Hello people, Bubble Whispers over here, and here's
Koala.
Today we want to talk about our living experience together, about moving in together as a couple. And first we're going to talk about experiences, how we used to live with our parents, and how now
we are living now together.
Yes.
Yes, and also I also live with a roommate, so it's also different. I will tell also my experience about that. And yes, let's start with your experience.
My experience is, I can tell you, I used to live with my parents and my little brother. To be honest, when I lived home, like doing the dishes, cooking, and doing the laundry, I hadn't worried about that because my mom did everything in the house. So. And when I live now live together, I also when I do the laundry, I do this for her, or otherwise she do that for me. I mean, there's a lot of things I had to do by myself. In the beginning, I had to. It just was different. I wouldn't even went away, weet je,
van. Yeah, adjust.
I had to adjust because living together is different than living with your parents. And it was my first time that I moved in with a partner. I have never lived with a roommate or something like that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I live with a roommate and with my parents. When I live with my parents and my little brother, it's a little bit like the same as yours. I didn't have to do everything in the household, but sometimes I helped a little bit, but not very much. But when I moved in with a roommate, I had to do the laundry by myself, the dishes, cleaning, everything. So that was very different. And also you have to respect each other. And you have to follow the rules. You don't have much privacy also, so it's very different. Sometimes it's also annoying because you are irritating each other with some points in life. So that was a little bit different and tough sometimes. But now living with you is also it's not very new, but it's different to live with a partner. I think you share everything, you talk about everything. Sometimes it can also be tough. Very in the beginning was tough. You have to, you were living home first with your parents. You didn't do much. And I was a little bit more experienced in that point.
But I also think when you live with your partner, there's some things you will accept easier than accepting from strangers.
Yeah, maybe.
And also because there are things I accept easier from my girlfriend than from my own family, because I'm not going to marry my parents in the future, you know?
Yeah.
This is how I'm saying, because I know we maybe we live 100 years together, but and when I see my own friends, they just still live with their own parents. I won't do that because I think it's just I'm happy, you know. It's just it's different.
Yeah, you
to
are
live
happy.
Your own partner is just I prefer that than living with my own parents.
You got more privacy. You can share everything with me, right?
And you can do all your own things.
Yeah, do your own things. You have space for you do your own things also.
I can cook my food that you also love. We can cook together. We can watch movie together. And we
can go out together.
Yeah.
Yeah, we have two bunnies together also.
Yeah, what?
That's our little babies we are taking care of.
I didn't have pets at home.
Yeah, little fishes.
I had also just a goldfish. But now living with her, I have two rabbits. I'm very happy. And that's the difference. And We also want to give advice, the last advice to people what to do when they're moving in.
Yeah.
The next time, we what we will do in the future and what we will not do.
Yeah.
The do's and don'ts.
The do's is to talk with each other about everything what you want in the house, like what kind of floor you want, how do you want to do it, do you want to do it by yourself, or do you want to let it do by somebody, or which color do you want on the wall, what kind of furniture do you want, what kind of decorations, that kind of stuff. That's a hard, that are very hard decisions. Because everyone has a different opinion and different wishes, but you have to compromise with each other because you're living together. So you cannot be selfish. You have to make a compromise with each other of all the wishes of each other. So if the talking with each other is very, very important, I think. And also our experience moving in is very stressful. So sometimes it's getting annoying. You can be mad at each other sometimes, but don't be mad for a long time. Just let it go. Take a rest. And maybe some things you can better do not by yourself, but by somebody else. Who we can, as example, the floor we did by ourselves. But it's it was very tough, and it take much time. So next time, I think, don't we do that again?
No, there are a lot of things. It's about communication, as you said, but also there are a lot of things. Instead of doing by ourselves, we can hire people. It's not expensive. So like we are moving next time, I mean we will hire someone and it will cost less stress, it will cost less energy for a little bit money. This is just that's what those advice of us. But this is everything, right? For but I think also next time, when you move in, I think also the big decision is to know where you could move in, the place, where you go. I think it's also important.
Don't rush. Yeah.
Think about good about it, because when you live together, it's not just for 3, 4, 5 days a holiday.
No,
you know,
it's different. It's different, like you're sleeping all weekend with each other, or or vacation. It's very different. I think you are 24/7. You are together, so it's different. Yeah, yeah. But it's not always roses and moonshine and that kind of stuff. Sometimes, you have words with each other, I think, but that's normal. But don't hang in it. You have to make it, right with each other again, because you're living together.
That's right. And that's all of things we have to say. Follow our advice. Think about carefully, and don't rush.
Also, with choosing the apartment or the house, you don't have to rush. Just look good at the price. Is it okay? Is the neighborhood okay? Is it good on the inside, on the outside? Are there some points that are not good? So think about it.
What's it? I hope you listen to our advice. about moving in together.
So are you happy?
I think
still happy.
Are happy together?
Yeah, are you still happy with me?
I think so. You?
Yeah.
Okay, guys. See you next time. Okay.
Okay. Bye. Bye.